May I introduce myself? My name is Martindale Marksman, but everyone calls me Mark for short. I don't suppose you ever heard a dog talk before, have you? As a matter of fact, my master arranged it specially. Tell you all about an adventure we had the other day. Between ourselves, it all began with Master. This is Master. Running after that pretty young widow next door. This is Widow. The one with the puppy mistress called Peggy. Not to mention that lazy lapdog Biddy. Look at her, snoozing on that cushion when she ought to be out hunting for rats. Well, as I was saying, the trouble started that evening when Master waited to see if Joan, that's the pretty widow, was going to take Biddy for walks. I waited too, with my head on my paws, like this. And then?
Biddy! Time for your walk. What is the matter with you? Don't you ever want to go for a walk?
Oh, hello, Joan.
Hello, Peter.
Going for a breather?
Just taking Biddy for a spot of exercise. It's such a lovely evening, isn't it?
Yes, it's grand. May I join you?
Do, please. I'd love it. Oh, look what they've done. Do try and keep Mark in order. He's been frightening Biddy. I might easily have fallen and hurt myself. And now look what he's done to my stocking. It is such a pity you can't control him.
I'm sorry about the stocking, but it wasn't all Mark's fault.
Well, you can't blame Biddy. She behaves perfectly until that draggled mongrel of yours interferes with her.
Mark isn't a mongrel, and I don't see how you can suggest that he's badly kept. In comparison with some dogs, I know he...
Meaning Biddy?
Well, if the cap fits...
Why, Biddy's worth 10 of that wretched Mark of yours. She's more intelligent, she's quiet, she's contented, and she behaves well.
Why, Joan, you're being ridiculous. You know as well as I do that it's a miracle that Biddy's as fit as she is. As for the way you care for it, it's a disgrace to anyone that's fond of their dog.
Please let me pass.
Certainly. You and me both. Come on over.
Well, that was that. And Master and I had to go for our walk by ourselves. I remember it very well because we crossed several of my old pals on the way. Crossing the bridge by the weir, we met the Colonel. He was in a very bad way. Had another attack of his gout. He'd been forgetting to take his Shirleys, I expect. Then I stopped to say hello to that nice little piece that lives at the local. I like her, even if she is inclined to be a bit standoffish. And after that, we had hardly turned the corner when who should come along with those two gay young cairns. Hello, twins.
Hello, Peggy.
Hello.
Want to watch the beauty treatment?
Yes, please.
Well, come on over and you can take a front seat.
What you doing?
Just giving Mark his daily brush. Yeah, that's good, isn't it?
Yes, but his coat isn't so nearly as nice as that.
No, but it would be if you looked after it properly. Now I'm going to give Mark his powder.
What you doing?
I told you I'm just going to give Mark his powder. Look, Shirley's tonic and condition powder. If you gave your dog a two-day course of this every week, she'd always be fitting well like Mark.
Up, Mark, get up, up.
Why, what does it do?
Oh, lots of things. Gives him a good appetite, keeps his coat healthy, makes him want to run and play. That's because it keeps his blood clean and healthy. Get up, Mark.
How'd you give it to him? Ah, Biddy won't take any medicine.
Oh, it's quite easy. I just shake it on the back of his tongue, like this. Watch.
He doesn't seem to mind a bit.
No, and neither would Biddy. You could put it in a little milk, and she'd never even know she'd taken it, because Shirley's powders are quite tasteless.
Are they? He wants to save him.
Of course he does. Come on, Abba. Better go.
Oh, brother.
Peggy. I thought I told you not to play with that objectionable dog next door.
But there isn't a objectionable dog.
Now, Peggy, don't answer me back. If you want a romp, there's always Biddy to play with.
But you won't play. He's not a bit jolly like Mark.
Nonsense. Biddy's a darling.
Then why doesn't you run races and play ball like Mark?
Because she's a nice ladylike dog and she's been brought up properly. Now run along and do as I say.
Walk with me and Mum in the country.
Come on, dear.
Come on, Ladybone.
But I must get on with my story. A couple of days later, I was down by our garden gate when I heard the widow and her little girl starting off for a picnic.
Hello, boy. What do you want? Oh, you want to go for a walk? Well, I suppose I'll get no peace until I take you.
Where is that dog? Biddy! Come along, Biddy!
Steady on, old boy. This isn't a race. Go on then, you idiot.
Just go in here, Mummy, and then you can have a race.
All right, darling. Hold Mummy's book. Come and tell me when you're hungry, darling. We'll have tea.
All right, Mum.
So the prince and the princess were married and lived happily ever.
Hey, Mark.
Hello, Peter.
Hello.
How's the patient?
I'm all right, thank you.
As a matter of fact, it's as much as I can do to make her rest.
Mummy?
Yes, darling?
Don't you think it's time we just started taking stress powder?
All right, darling, I'll see about it today. Now you must go to sleep.
All right, Mummy.
Say goodbye to Mark.
Goodbye, Mark.
Goodbye, Peter. Thanks for everything.
Goodbye.
Well, I take back anything I said about that lapdog Biddy. She's been a different woman since taking Shirley's powder. As for me, I'd never have been able to save Peggy if I hadn't been in perfect condition. You see, I've always taken Shirley. It's the only way a fellow like me can keep really fit. You try them, too. Tell your master every chemist or coal merchant sells them. Shirley's tonic and condition powders, if you want to be a healthy chap.